Unity Splines coming up. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hi everyone, this is Omar Bofiki. If you're a subscriber, welcome back. If not, welcome to this channel where I create game development tutorials and from time to time I upload my short films. If you're interested, subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video is uploaded. And before starting, I just want to say that it's almost 2 weeks before the launch of my Unity Filmmaking 101 course. If you'd like to hear more about it and get exclusive discounts, please subscribe to the newsletter and you will receive updates. And one more thing, I just want to thank Unity for sponsoring this tutorial. We'll talk more about that in a bit. In this tutorial, we'll take a look at Unity's Spline system, which is really an interesting feature. And so far, it's really fun to play with. So first thing first, you need to have Unity 2022.1 and above. So to install it, go to Window and then Package Manager. And make sure that you're logged in. We're going to go to Unity Registry and search for Spline. Since I already have it, I don't see install, but you should see install. Hit install and you should have it ready. Now, once you've installed it, go to the hierarchy, right click, and you will see Spline. And you got these couple of options and then Draw Splines tool. The only difference is that these are predefined shapes, and then the Draw Splines tool gives you the freedom to draw around, and that's what we want. I'm just going to name that Spline Test 1. All right, so you see on the left side here, we're in the Spline Edit mode or whatever it's called. And then here we're adding new points. So you can see wherever I point the mouse or the cursor, you'll see this small icon. If I click, it starts drawing. So I can just have fun and draw whatever shape I want. I can leave it as is or I can close it, so I will close that. And once you're done, hit the escape button. And now it has drawn this shape. This tutorial is sponsored by Unity, and Unity 2022 LTS Editor is finally released. An LTS version means it has been developed and tested for 2 years and will be supported for another 2 years. I strongly recommend that you download it and play with it, especially if you're starting with a new project, as it's the most stable edition. It has a lot of updates for some of the features and packages, including dots, ECS, netcode, and splines, which is the topic of today's tutorial, and many more updates. To read more, check out the blog post link in the description. And back to the tutorial. All right, now what can we do with this shape? There are three things you can do with the spline tool, and all of these three are really interesting. Let's take a look at each one of them. The first thing you can do is extrude. So if I add component and type extrude or just spline, you will see the options. And let's select extrude. And then you see it has this sort of pipe shape. So what we can do is decrease the Y scale to something like 0.1 and increase the radius. So we have this sort of street or road look, which is pretty interesting. If I move anything, it moves accordingly and regenerates the mesh for us. So I can even assign it to a material, and I have this street material. And we can play around with the tiling to find the fit we like. And then even in the range, we can specify where it starts or end and play around with that. But for now, I just leave it as is, and then later we'll show you some interesting stuff you can do with the range. So that's the first thing. The second thing, I'm just going to remove the extrude and all of these things with it. The other thing you could do is instantiate. And instantiate, as the name suggests, it will instantiate objects along the spline path. So we're going to add one item here, and I'm just going to select any of the objects from the scene. I'm going to select one of the rocks. And I'm going to duplicate that using my tool, OB Object Placer. I'm just going to duplicate it here. And I'm just going to take it out from the parents group, put it here. And I'm going to unpack the prefab completely and just take the first LOD. Now I can go to the spline test and drag this object here. And you will see it has used that object. It looks really weird, but we can solve that by increasing the distance between one rock and the other. Or we can play around with the offsets over here. So I'm going to play with the scale. You can either have exact or random values, but let's say we choose random values. So now we're decreasing the size of it. And we can even add some random Y rotation. So as you can see, we just instantiated these guys. And we can add another one. I'm just going to type forest. We can select from the scene or from the assets. I am searching from the assets. So I'm going to select this tree. So we probably don't see it. Let's give it 70% and 30% to the rocks. You can see the trees are here, but they're too small. I'm just going to remove the scale offset. And you can see them already. Their sizes are just okay. One thing we can do is we can scale down the reference rock and go back to the spline and hit regenerate, and it will take that into effect. So I'm just going to remove that. And now let's talk about the third thing that we could do with the spline tool. And by the way, the spring sales are almost finished. So if you haven't got anything, I strongly suggest to go and check it out. Probably you'll find something you want for a discounted price. And just a disclaimer, it's an affiliate link. So if you buy through the links in the description, I'll get a commission and that will definitely help the channel. So thanks and back to the tutorial. Let's create an object, cube for instance, and we can add spline animate. This is pretty cool, and I really enjoy playing around with this one. Once you add a spline animate to the cube or the object you want to move, it requires a spline container. So I'm just going to drag the spline test we just created. And here we can just hit play and look at the magic. Well, it moves too fast. Here we have the duration. We can either play it by time or speed. Time means it will take a full circle in X seconds. Speed is how fast it is. So let's go with time and say we wanted to finish the circle in 7 seconds. Something more believable. And here another example. One of the recent tutorials, I talked about the HDRP clouds and we had fun with that. And we had this spaceship that was flying through the clouds. I used actually Spline and look how it looks like. Well, it flies in the air. And then the cameras are switching. The switch is pretty simple. We just have a cinema scene track that switches between two cameras. And we have the ship flying around. I can even decrease the time 10 seconds and look how fast it flies. Crazy. All right, so here is another example using the spline tool to create the road and these sort of fences and the object moving through that as a car, which is just a simple cube. As you can see here, the fence, I just created two objects and dragged them into this empty game object so I can change the pivot so it instantiates the fence from that place. So as you can see, they are created in a perfect spot with this distance. It starts almost from the beginning of the road. So if I hit play, look what we have here. The car is just moving through that weird road. And another thing we can play with, if you go to the Spline Extrude, we can modify and play around with the start and end of the road. It always starts from 0 to 100. It's a fixed value, but you can modify that. And as you can see, it moves like a snake. So if I disable the spline instantiate and move it around, you'll see it looks like a snake. However, I tried animating these values and I tried enabling the auto region geometry, but it didn't work for me. Auto region geometry means that whenever I change these values, it will regenerate the geometry. But somehow it only works when I modify the values from the editor. I tried modifying these values from the timeline via animation and also tried modifying them from a script, but apparently nothing triggers the regeneration except modifying from the editor itself. So I created this simple script, which basically does the same thing. And then I call rebuild, which acts as auto regeneration for the geometry with a parameter or a variable to skip frames for optimization purposes. So now if I enable that and then I go to the timeline here, I modified the script, the from and to from 0 to 20 to 80 to 100. So as you can see, the values are moving here. And we have a auto regen enabled, and we're skipping two frames. If I hit play, look at the magic. Now it's working just fine. I can increase the skipping frames to 15, and it looks something like a stop motion or cartoonish look. So that's basically it. I hope you guys found this video helpful, and remember to subscribe to the newsletter to get updates when the course is out, and also whenever new videos are uploaded, exclusive discounts, and so on. This is Omar Bafaki. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.